Here's a Beyond the Pitch podcast quick hit from the WVSA Digital Network.
Yeah, this is one of my passions. I love treating people post-concussion. And I think there's a lot more education in the world about this now because of all the research that's coming out. And I just want to say this on the podcast, and I want people to know that there is no imaging you can do that's going to diagnose a concussion. Mm-hmm. So just because you have a nice x-ray, because you have a pretty MRI, does not mean that you don't have a concussion.
Right.
And I want that myth debunked forever. So please add that to the podcast when it gets published.
Yeah.
But concussions are different for everyone. Again, and if you sustain a head injury, you know, with headers, or if you have a fall and hit your head on the field, this is very significant. You don't have to lose consciousness to have a concussion. You know, headaches are very common, fatigue, loss of concentration, poor sleep, dizziness. A lot of things like that can be swept under the rug. Oh, you just hit your head. Well, that it's a lot more significant than that. And that's where we go back to, when can I play again? Definitely want to be assessed. If you think you have a concussion, go see, you know, hopefully a physical therapist near you is good at treating these, or an athletic trainer. Typically any of those types of providers will be able to give you some good return to play criteria. And some people will go through that faster than others. But if you go return to play too soon, you can sustain a very, very, it could be very actually deadly if you are going back too soon. And I don't want to scare anyone, but it can be something you just don't want to mess with.